slaves would use different signs and symbols and signals when they were making their escape from the south up here to north to Canada to freedom. And one of them that they would use was the North Star. And the North Star would be found when you would find the Big Dipper in the sky. And the Little Dipper is just directly above it. So you'd have to follow the handle of the Little Dipper down to the Big Dipper. And that's where the North Star is situated. But if it was cloudy at night and you couldn't find the North Star, they would feel for the moss that grows on the north side of the tree. They would also talk in codes as well. Different places and different people had names. The people who helped them were called conductors. Like Harriet Tubman, she was a conductor, and her nickname was Moses. People were baggages or cargo. Little children were packages. Males were referred to as hardware. Females were dry goods. Different places had different names. Sandusky, Ohio was sunrise. Cleveland, Ohio was hope. Detroit was midnight. But when they entered into Canada, they gave them words of praise and thanksgiving to God. So Windsor was glory to God, and Port Stanley was God be praised. They also sang songs. A lot of the different spirituals that we still sing, there are a lot of meaning in them, and people sometimes don't realize when they are singing what they are singing about. The songs, not only did they sustain them on that perilous journey, but they also gave them faith and hope. When they sang, "Go down, Moses, let my people go," they were referring to Harriet Tubman. That meant that she was in the area, you know, so pay attention and listen because she's going to help you escape to freedom. Wading in the water was another one because they always followed the waterways to take the scent off from the dogs. Steal away to Jesus, steal away to freedom, to Canada. They were very... They had very unique ways. They were very smart and crafty people, not that very stereotypical, lazy, the myth that has been passed down from generation to generation.
And the Underground Railroad itself, what is it?
It's not a railroad that runs underground, and it's not a tunnel. But sometimes they did follow the railroad, the tracks on the railroad. It was an illegal, secretive network of people, both black and white, that were helping slaves escape from the south up here to Canada. And they would house them in barns. They would house them in the floor joists or in between walls, in their attics, even in covered wagons. However they could hide and help them, they would do that. But if they were caught, they were chastised. Sometimes they were put to death, or sometimes they were fined. Usually they were killed.
And the route coming into Canada would primarily be from where? Like the Niagara?
Niagara was an excellent crossing point. Niagara-Buffalo because of the river. Also Detroit-Windsor and Lake Erie, which is just south from here, they would cross. Sometimes they would escape in the winter because the lakes would be frozen over and they could walk across the rivers at that time. Also they would escape in the winter at around Christmas because the master would be up in the plantation at his big house, partying, etc., and wouldn't really worry too much about the slaves, that would back down on the plantation. So they would have a couple of days of leeway, grace time, if you will, of escaping. And sometimes they would even run in the spring when the foliage was just coming out and there were berries and there was a lot of rain that would also help with, getting the scents off from the dogs as well.
And the settlers that were hearing from Buxton, where did they come?
Variety of states. You know, your neighbors could come from, you could have a neighbor from Virginia or Tennessee or Kentucky or Maryland or Pennsylvania. It was very, not funny, but it was just seemed like you had neighbors from every part of the United States escaping here or coming to Buxton.
Did some of them come by just crossing Lake Erie?
Some did, and I'm trying to think how many, and I don't know which ones did, but yes, they would have done that. There was a whole area in, I'm trying to think what state it was, maybe in Ohio, that just sort of, when you look at the census from the early 1800s, it just sort of picked up from there and it came over here to Buxton. You know, things, it's just amazing the distance they did travel for that freedom.
Let's go.